Hey guys, so welcome back to today's tutorial. In this video, we're gonna learn how to make this trendy blouse with a C-cut armhole. Okay, I made use of Akara fabric. The blouse is fully lined, and we made use of the pattern from our previous video. Please check the previous video on how to cut a princess that bustier. So I used my previous pattern. I placed it on my Akara to get my basic bodice. Okay, so when I was done cutting out, I also cut out my lining. Like I said, the blouse was fully lined. Okay, to give a bit of structure. After cutting out the front, I also cut out the back. I open up that line still at the back. I'll go ahead and close up the dart which I opened at the back. Okay, so like so. So next thing I want to do is to mark my neckline. I used 3 inches by 1.5 at the back neckline. And I'm also going to reduce the length of the lining at the base by 1 inch to enable it to turn up after sewing. Okay, so this is a high neck. It's a high neck. So I use 3 inches by 1.5 so that it just grips my neckline. Okay, so after marking, you cut it out like so. Next thing you want to do is mark out 1 inch from after where your neckline ended, and also blend to get the C curve. You have to blend it from the armhole, which you've marked already, to meet the 1 inch which at the neckline. So you cut it, and that is how it's gonna look like. That's how to get the C curve. And I go below, like the tip of the blouse. Your lining has to be shorter than your fabric. So what I did was I cut out 1 inch to enable it turn up after I stitch it up. So that's that back. Now I go to the front. I close up my dart too at the front. Then I also reduce my lining by 1 inch, what I also did for the back. Then for the neckline, I use 3 inches by 2.5. Okay, then I connect it together like so and cut off. So you remember we also use 1 inch for trying to get the sleeve, the shoulder, this sleeve. You do the same thing for the front. You mark 1 inch, then you also connect it. You blend it to the armhole with a curve, with a C curve. You determine the depth, like how much exposure you want first. That's what I just did. I came down by 8 inches and I connected it to my armhole like so. If you want yours to go lower, if you want yours to be higher, it's dependent on what you want. So when you open it up, this is what it's gonna look like. So you place your lining on your fabric and you go to your sewing machines and you stitch up the sides neatly, and this is what you're gonna have. You repeat the same thing for the back. You sew as shown, so as to make it come out nicely. After sewing, this is what you have, and you notice the turn up at the base. That's because of the 1 inch you deducted from the lining. So after turning, this is my front, this is my back. I place my back on my front to be able to join the shoulder to shoulder together. If you've gotten here thus far, kindly hit the subscribe button below, like and share our content, turn on post notifications so you'll be first notified when we post new content weekly. So back to our video. After joining the shoulder to shoulder, this is what we have. So you now go ahead to shape your blouse. Okay, as you can see, it's coming, it has, you can see how neat the C curve on the armhole looks like, sitting pretty. So now it's time for us to shape. You now remark your shoulder to bust, shoulder to under bust, shoulder to your half length, the length of the blouse, and you take the vertical and horizontal measurements. After shaping, this is what you have. You give it a good press so it lays down flat and nice. So now is now the time to fix our sleeve. If you decide to leave yours like this, then it's good and fine because the armhole has been sealed off. So now it's time I fold the remaining fabric into two. You can use as much fabric as you have available or how as full as you want it to be. So this is all the fabric I have left. I fold it into two and also fold again into two to get the two sleeves at the same time. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is decide at the position of your sleeve, how low or how high you want it. I measured 4 inches from my armhole, so that's where I'm going to be placing my sleeve on. So I measured, I came up from the joining of my armhole by 4 inches. Then I indicated on the part where I want the sleeve to be. So you just cut it straight. You just cut a straight line. You leave room for where the elastic will be, because the elastic is supposed to grip the sleeve together. So after putting the elastic at the top and the bottom of the sleeve, this is what we look like. You just close the sides and you attach your sleeve, easy peasy. Okay, so thank you for coming this far watching our video. If you'd like to see more of these videos, kindly subscribe to our channel, share our link, like and leave comments in the comment section and I'll respond to you. When we are done, this is what we have, easy peasy. You can choose to attach a band at the neckline, which I did for mine, or you can leave it the way it is. Okay, thank you for watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye.